Let us welcome to my second class of Laplace transform. In the previous class, we already discussed why you need to study for Laplace transform, what are the few applications based on Laplace transform. Now, let us consider now what's the definition of Laplace transform. Laplace transform for the function f of x is denoted by L of f of x is defined as 0 to infinity e power of minus st into f of t with respect to t, where s is a parameter of the transform. Once you evaluate this integral based on f of t, finally we get a solution or we get a result in terms of parameter or maybe a constant. That is denoted by, for our convenience, is say is denoted by f of s. I told in my previous class, in some of the textbook in the post-subject textbook, they are going to use omega also. Or some of the textbook, they are going to use alpha. Alpha must be same. Now, once you apply the inverse transform, say, now that implies, now once you apply inverse transform, means L inverse of L of f of x is nothing but L inverse of f of s. L of L inverse of function is given as the function itself, means f of x. Just like a differentiation and integration of the function is function itself. It's nothing but L inverse of f of s. Once you apply the inverse transform for this parameter, that gives us the corresponding function. Now later we have discussed the inverse transform. First we have to consider, based on the definition of Laplace transform, some of the standard functions. Say first function is a Laplace transform of a constant. Say Laplace transform of A. A may be a negative, A may be a positive, A may be a some constant value. I want to find out what's the Laplace transform of constant. It's nothing but, now this can be written as Laplace transform of, from the definition of Laplace transform, what we get actually 0 to infinity. What is my f of t from the definition A into e power of minus st with respect to t. We already know that fundamental integration, while doing integration we have to keep the constant outside. What's the integration of e power of minus st? E power of minus st divided by the quotient of s. What's the quotient of, quotient of t? What's the quotient of t is s. What's the limit? 0 to infinity. Before going to apply the upper and lower limit, better to keep the constant outside. What is my constant now? Minus a by s. Because we already evaluated with respect to t, now we are going to apply the limit instead of t only. E power of minus infinity minus e power of minus 0. Now, these are the fundamental things. You already know that e power of minus infinity is nothing but 1 by e power of infinity. E power of infinity is infinity. Now, 1 by infinity, the value of 1 by infinity is 0, since infinity is nothing but 1 by 0. And also, e power of minus 0 is nothing but 1 by e power of 0. What is e power of 0? Is 1. 1 by 1 is 1. Therefore, now, minus a by s of e power of minus infinity 0 minus 1. Minus e to minus plus, what do we get? A by s. Laplace transform of constant A is nothing but A by S. This implies Laplace transform of 1, A is equal to 1, means what? 1 by S. This is one of the standard function we treated while solving a problem. We are going to use just like a standard function. No need to derive this. Similarly, the Laplace transform of exponential function, second term, now only I have considered some standard functions. Laplace transform of e power of at, a is a constant, a may be a negative, a may be a positive, may be a fraction. Now from the definition of Laplace transform, 0 to infinity, the function f of t is nothing but what? E power of at into e power of minus st with respect to t. This is of same, add up the indices, what we get actually? 0 to infinity e power of Why we have to take care for this? While taking the t is outside, we have to take simultaneously minus also. I am going to explain further why I am going to take, even though minus n is not a common factor, I take it of minus n outside, a minus of s minus a into t with respect to t. I told why I'm going to take minus sign outside instead of, even though you don't have a common factor, while applying the limit I'm going to explain. Then it's from the basic definition of integration, e power of minus r s minus a into t divided by the quotient of t is s minus a. Limit is 0 to infinity. Now, while applying the limit, I'll keep minus of s minus a outside. And then apply the upper limit. What is my upper limit now? Infinity. Once you apply the infinity, what we get? E power minus infinity. Just now I discussed in the previous thing, e power minus infinity is 0. That's why I have taken, even though minus n is not a common factor. Suppose you are not taken minus n outside, what we get actually? E power of a minus s into t. Integrate it. Now what we get actually this one? E power of a minus s into t divided by a minus s. Apply the upper limit. What is upper limit here? Infinity. Once you apply the upper limit infinity, what is e power of infinity? Infinity. E power of 0 is 1. But we are expecting a finite value, but here we get infinite value. Therefore, whenever we are going to take common factor, especially for exponential function, you take plus or minus depending upon the upper and lower limit. Suppose having finite value is okay. Whenever having infinite value, you take, once you apply infinite value, you are expecting finite value. Because of that, here, even though it is not a common factor, I take a minus and outside. What's the thing here? Minus 1. So, then apply the limit, what we get? E power of minus infinity. Now, just now I discussed in the previous problem. Therefore, I am going to write what is directly, what is e power of minus infinity? 0. Minus e power of 0 is 1. What we get finally? 1 by s minus a. Therefore, Laplace transform of e power of at is what actually? 1 by s minus a. Now, a, now suppose Laplace transform of e power of minus at means what actually? Instead of a, what we get minus, we get s plus a. These are the standard function. Not only this, now I am going to take the next function is trigonometry function. But I am not going to derive from the board both the trigonometry function. I am considering cos function, similarly do it for sine function. Now, what is Laplace transform of cos AT? And also, what is the Laplace transform of sine of AT? Yeah. Now first I am going to take what the Laplace transform cos AT. From the definition of Laplace transform, this can be written as 0 to infinity. The function is e power of minus st into cos of AT with respect to t. Now we are going to evaluate this integral by using fundamental integral formula. You already studied that integral formula in PU level. The formula is integration of e power of ax into cos of bx plus r minus c with respect to x is nothing but e power of ax divided by quotient of x in exponential is a square of that, and then quotient of x in trigonometry function is b square of that of a into quotient of x in exponential into cos of bx plus r minus c minus b into sine of bx plus r minus c. Are you clear this point? Yes. Now, this is a formula you already studied, where you already studied in PU level. Even though I studied, now I am going to consider this. This proof, this how you get this formula, you refer any second PC textbook. You get this formula from reduction method. You already derived this result made in PU level, therefore we treat it as a formula. From this formula, what we get actually? E power of minus st divided by minus s whole square, because my a is minus s, what is my b is a, plus a square of, yeah, what is a? A is minus s into cos of at minus b. What is b? A into sin of at. The limit is 0 to infinity. Now here we get 1 by, before going to apply the limit, I told number of times, I have to keep the constant outside. What's the constant now? 1 by square plus a square, apply the upper limit. What is my upper limit? Is infinity. Once you apply this infinity, most of the students, they are going to confuse this part. Now, once you apply the upper limit, what happens? Here we get e power of minus infinity. I am taking separately of cos infinity and then minus sin infinity, we get something, right? E power of minus infinity is what? 0 into this cos infinity, sin infinity is infinity. Actually, once you apply the limit, upper limit for this function, what we get here? 0 to infinity. Please observe carefully. Once you apply the limit, what happened? E power of minus infinity. What is e power of infinity? 0. Therefore, most of them, they are telling, no, e power of minus infinity is 0. Therefore, we are taking 0. Not like that. E power of minus infinity is 0, but the product is infinity. 0 to infinity is an indeterminate form. You can't take any finite or infinite value. By using the L'Hospital rule, means if you want to apply the L'Hospital rule, you take product of any one of the functions in the denominator. You take e power of minus 16 in the denominator. Now, we get what actually? S cos a t minus whatever that a sin a t divided by e power of s t. You apply one or two times whatever differentiation, apply once or twice of L'Hospital rule. After first or second time, definitely we get the value of the limit is 0. That's why because of that, we are going to take upper limit, the value, once you apply that, we get 0 into infinity. But applying L'Hospital rule, before going to apply the L'Hospital rule, take product of one of the functions, the denominator, we get which one? Infinity by infinity. Apply one or two times L'Hospital rule, finally we get the value of the limit is 0. Minus low limit, what's the low limit here? Low limit is 3 power of 0 is 1 of minus s into what is cos 0 is 1 minus sin 0 is 0. Now we get minus into minus plus, what's the thing? S square plus a square. Therefore, what is Laplace transform of cos a t here? S square, s square plus a square. Similarly, you find out Laplace transform of which function? Sin at. How to find out? See, observe same formula. Instead of cos, what we get? Sin. Once you take sin, then apply the formula. You have formula for based on sin also. You refer second QC textbook. We get apply simplify that. Finally, we get the answer is sin by s square plus a square. I am not going to discuss similar type function in the class. Okay, now let us move to the next hyperbolic function. Okay, yes, now the next is hyperbolic function. The hyperbolic function is Laplace transform of sin at and also Laplace transform of cos hyperbolic at, cos at or cos hyperbolic at, and also I have to discuss Laplace transform of t power of n. Yeah, I am going to consider these functions in my next class. Thank you very much for listening my talk.